Good morning, my dear students. In chapter kinematics, we are going to discuss the topic numericals on uniform velocity motion. So if you can recollect, in the previous class we had a discussion on the instantaneous velocity and the uniform velocity motion. That one, we had only the theoretical description, everything. Okay, now today what happened, we are going to take help of the different numericals, so where we can in depth get the difference between instantaneous and average speed, and what do you mean by uniform velocity motion. I picked up some good numericals also where you can understand the all the theoretical ideas which I'm going to what I discussed previous class. Now we can explore that in the form of numericals. So let me take you to the screen. Okay, here we have the first numerical. Your first name. A person moves along a straight line, a distance s1 with a speed v1 and the distance s2 with a speed v2. Find average velocity of the motion. Find the average velocity for the motion. For the whole motion. Okay, now say how to don't go for formula. Some will suggest you like okay directly okay remember formula. The physics is not about the formulas. Formulas is the last concluding part. So you should not depend on concluding part. Better analyze. A person moves along a straight line. I think you can walk. So first let me walk a distance s1 with a speed v1. Then I'll walk a distance S2 with the speed V2. So here I myself, you can see this is actually the thing. So I'm going to run with the speed how much? V1. I'll indicate. So how much of distance I'll walk? S1. Then here the myself only. Here I'm going to run or a walk with the speed V2. So what is the distance I'll cover it? Will be S2. So he's asking now to get that average velocity. So will I take any time? As definitely to walk that distance, I will take some time. So let the time taken to move a distance, let it be t1. Time taken to move a distance, let it be t2. I think I feel like anybody can understand this method. Anybody. I'll let things. Slowly, I don't bother about the numericals. Numerical solving physics numericals is not about some tricks or some formulas. I'll apply, then I'll get it. So that may not help you in all cases. So better have a universal method which is applicable at all things. He's asking average velocity. So what is the basic definition of average velocity? Distance covered by time taken. Total distance by total time. Total distance, it will move a distance S1, then S2. What are time? T1, T2. These are things what we assume, no? T1, T2. Okay, looking at the diagram, what is V1 you can write? S1, T1. That V1 is what? Instantaneous or so like a uniform speed. It will move with a constant speed. V1 for certain time, then you'll move it next with another constant speed V2 for certain time. So this V1 is what, like a uniform speed. In uniform speed, what will happen to average velocity and instantaneous velocity? Both will be same. Getting the idea? This one. So then similarly, so T1 is unknown, so can I replace? No. T1, what I can write it as S1 by V1, S2 by V2. So finally, our answer will be V1, V2, S1 plus S2. This will be V2, S1 plus V1, S2. This will be the average speed for its motion. So one thing, it's clear. What is this V1? Is it instantaneous or average? both same for uniform velocity. For uniform velocity motion, V average is equal to V instantaneous. Along a straight line, it is. This is what we are. We took help of this one. Let me proceed to the next numerical. A person moves along a straight line with a speed v1 for time t1 and with a speed v2 for time t2. Find average velocity. I think the same set of diagram is there. So I think that everything is same. Only thing is, what are the known things? V1 and T1 are known. S1, S2 is unknown. So what is average velocity again? How do we write? Total distance covered by total time taken. S1, S2 are unknown. So what is V1? You can write it as S1 by T1. V2, S2 by T2. Substitute S1, V1, T1, V2, T2. This is T1 plus T2. If you want, you can also, what you can do, you can also do this by another method. What is another method? Graph, using graph also. So if you plot the graph, it will move with a velocity V1. For certain time, then with a velocity V2 for other time. Then this should be this time should be T1. What is this time? This should be T2. Distance covered. Okay, there's a position. No? Mm-hmm. I'll indicate like this. This will be S1. This will be S2. So there's a position versus time graph. Is asking average velocity. So what you are going to do? From ST graph, can you calculate the average velocity? Distance called by time taken. Already have distance. The distance is unknown thing. May not help you, but I just showing you that one. So here, what happened? The slope of this curve, what it will give? It will give the instantaneous velocity. And definitely the velocity is, the slopes are different. So therefore, definitely what we can say that the person is moving with a different speed in different intervals of time. There's a basic idea. Like this graph also, you can take help of it. So what is the total distance covered? S1 plus F. Total time of journey is T1 plus T2. So we don't know that S1 and S2. So what is S1? You can write it here from here. It's not VT graph. It's a ST graph, that one. From ST graph. No, sir. Can you show by VT graph? Yes, we can also draw the VT graph. What is there in that one? So if I plot this, it will move with a velocity. First, even horizontal line, let me take it. May not be needed. Yeah, this is the speed V1 with which the person will be moving. Here, this is V2. This time interval is T1. this is T2. Okay, now you have everything in front of you. How to calculate S1? This will be the S1. No, I think I'll shade it. Provided if you know, if you are very good in plotting graphs, you can take help of this also. This S1. So then what is S2? Some other colors. Let's take this. Area under this curves will give the distance. Area of that gray color, this area under this, what is area V1 into T1? Then what is the area of this? Will be V2 is the height, and breadth is, length is T2 and height is V2, no? So V2, T2 will be the area of this pink color region. V1, T1 is area of this pink color. The area in VT graph, velocity versus time graph, what it will give? Displacement or distance curve. Since it's motion along straight line, no? So this should be equal to distance covered. I think very simple. This area, I'll write A1, A2. What is A1? V1, T1. What is A2? V2, T2. This area will become distance. Later, we are going to discuss in detail. So like this, you can draw this VT graph also. Nothing wrong. Try. Nothing wrong is there. So trying to learn a different method, nothing wrong. A particle travels half the distance with a velocity V0. The remaining half the distance was covered in two equal intervals with velocity V1 and V2 respectively. Find the average velocity of particle for whole journey. Okay, I think you have to really put effort here. So what is the method? What is the method? See, like physically the motion takes place, no? That has to be expressed here. The motion, how it occurs, that has to be expressed. So how that motion occurs here. So first we'll do one thing. I will write it. It will start at A with a particle travels half the distance with a velocity V0, half, exactly half I'll make it. So this will be B. C and D. Okay, the total distance is how much? Okay, let's assume this is L. Half the distance, it will be traversed with a speed L/2. Or so like with a speed V0, half the distance is L. The total distance is L. I'm assuming that L is the assumption. With a velocity V0, it will cover half the distance. Then the remaining half the distance. So the remaining half the distance is, it will be how much? It is equal to, the remaining half distance will be L/2 only. Was covered in two equal intervals. So here, how much of time it will take? Say T0. Then how much of time it will take? Two equal intervals. So these two times must be same. With a speed V1, this will be speed V2. Hope if you are, so what is this dotted line? This is the path. This is very important. And then graph. A student must plot this, how that physically that motion is taking place. Once you are aware of this, it'll be very easy. So first, it is a person, a particle, or you can write it as a person or some vehicle, anything. Sir, what do you mean by particle? Or vehicle, or person walking. anything you can take. Why we go for particle? Because all this physics, what we are discussing, you know, it started around almost, you can take 12th, 13th or 15th century. At the time, we didn't have the vehicle, am I right? The what we see, locomotive engines, now what we see, you know, these vehicles were not there. So how to describe the motion of a body? So they just assumed that all the theoretical discussions were made related to a particle. Then later on, as the technology got improved, engineering technology, we were able to bring all the different types of vehicles. So nothing wrong. You can take your any bike if you have, two-wheeler bike, that also you can take example here to understand. Okay, first you will walk off of the distance with a speed V0. The remaining off in two equal intervals of time with two different speeds, V1 and V2. Is asking, get the average velocity. Now, what is the basic definition of average velocity? What are this T0? What are assumptions? L is an assumption. This is not given. We are assuming it. Even this T0T is also assumption. You see that one. What are the known things? The known things are only these things, no? V0, V1, V2. Our answer should be in terms of V0, V1, and V2. So first we'll write expression in terms of all the things what we have indicated in the diagram. Then we'll see how we can eliminate the assumed things. So what is the basic definition of average velocity? Total distance covered by total time. No, total V average, total distance, what are the distance? AB plus BC plus CD. Time taken, T0 plus T by 2. I think the problem is solved. So what is AB? AB is V0, T0. What is the distance AB? You can write it as V0, the distance AB, you can write V0 into T0. Okay, I'll write few steps. Huh? It'll be easier. V0 should be equal to AB by T0. The distance BC is covered with a speed in an interval of time T by 2. Similarly, the distance CD is covered in an interval of time T by 2 with speed V2. So let me replace now. V average AB equal to V0 T0. BC is equal to V1 T by 2. V2 T by 2. Equal to T0 plus T. Write this equation 1. What are unknown things? T0 and T. These are things which we assumed it. T0 and T is what we assumed it. So they should be eliminated. I need one more equation. So I'll take help of this one. So what is the condition given? That AB is equal to BC plus CD, half of the length. You can see this. Remaining of the distance. So from the diagram, AB equal to BC plus CD. What is AB? V0, T0. What is BC? V1, T by 2. V2, T by 2. So what is the expression for T will be 2 V0, T0 by V1 plus V2. I think this, let me call equation 2. Let me substitute 2 in 1. In place of T by 2, I can write it as V0, T0, V1 plus V2. So in place of T, 2 V0, T0 by V1 plus V2. T0 in the numerator, denominator, taking common will get eliminated. I'll just highlight it so that it'll be easy for you. So this will get eliminated. So finally, what is V average? V0, V1 plus V2. I think even that V0 also is getting eliminated, no? okay, your V1, V2 get eliminated. So this will become V0, V1, 1 plus. So this will be 2V0, V1 plus V2. Okay, this will be your answer. If you want, you can draw the. If you want, you can draw the graph also, but may not be needed. I'll show the complete problem. You can view once. Yeah. Okay, so this was the discussion what we had. So I think that this diagram is very important. Unless a student doesn't draw this, may not be either you should imagine. Either you should have this imagination or else draw the diagram. Not imagination, no diagram, directly, sir, like can you give one formula, a substitute? Not possible. You can never learn physics in this way. We are at a very beginning stage. So better let's get habituated. Let's make an habit of like the moment you read question, let's try to draw one diagram. Looking at diagram, we'll try to understand. First, we'll understand the question. Then again, we'll read once again the question. Then we'll have a diagram, then known things will indicate, unknown things will indicate, then how known and unknown things can be related. We'll try to search one formula, then we'll see how many knowns or unknowns are there, then how many equations I can write, then the mathematics. So if you put effort possible, if you put effort, it's possible. Okay, let's take the next question. A body moves in a straight line with velocity v for time t naught. Then its velocity becomes. Okay, now this question. A body moves in a straight line with velocity v for time t naught. Then its velocity becomes 2v for next t naught time. Finally, its velocity becomes 3v for time t. If average velocity during the complete journey. If average velocity during the complete journey was 2.5 V, then find the value of capital T by T naught. Again, the same geometry, select the path. We'll draw a path. This actual path or the physical motion that occurs. So first it will move in a straight line with velocity V. Then velocity becomes 2V for next time T naught. And finally, it becomes 3V for time T. That's all finished, very simple. So it will move with a speed here V, 2V and 3V. What about the time? This is T naught. This is T naught. This is capital T. Whatever the distance covered, we don't know. Let it be x1, x2, and x3. So how you will define average speed? Average speed is defined as total distance covered by total time of journey. Total time of journey is T naught plus T naught and T. Okay, what is x1? V T naught. Look at this one. It's a uniform here, uniform speed. Again, the speed changes. Again, it starts moving with uniform speed. Again, with a uniform speed here. Three different types of motions are there, like here. It will move with uniform speed for a time T naught. Next, with a uniform speed 2V for time, another time interval T naught. Next, with uniform speed 3V for time interval T. So X1 is equal to V T naught. X2 is equal to 2V T naught. X3 is equal to 3V T. By 2t naught plus t. What is V average given? 2.5 times of V. So this will become 3 V T naught. Okay, V gets eliminated. This will be 5/2. We'll write it 5/2 is equal to 3 T naught capital T by 2 T naught plus T. Let me further solve it. So this will become 5 T naught, 5 capital T by 2, 3 T naught plus 3 T, 2 T naught T by 2. 5/2 will be 2.5, 3 minus 2.5 will be 0.5 or T by 2. So the ratio of T by T naught it is asking. So that should be the 4. This will be our answer. Yes, you have to understand, nothing is there. Somehow if you can imagine this, writing equation, these are definitions, these are formulas. Okay, no, I'm not asking you to don't memorize this. Average velocity, total distance by time taken. But you can't memorize what like that formula. So can you give one formula so that, okay, maybe you can solve this problem, not another problem. No, let's focus on some graphical questions. So I do have the position versus time graph. Let me save that. Yeah. So the position versus time graph of a vehicle moving along a straight line is as shown. What all will get information? If I calculate the slope in position versus time graph, what it will give? It will give us the velocity. And if the slope is constant, then the definitive velocity is constant. Velocity is constant, uniform velocity motion. So already let's go back to the definition of instantaneous speed, V instantaneous. Oh, what is the method? Slope of tangent drawn in ST graph will give instantaneous velocity. And look at the slope for this curve for 0 to 4 seconds. What is the slope? 10/4. So therefore, what is there for T? For T between 0 to 4 seconds, the instantaneous speed is given by, I'll just write V in, or okay, we'll use same symbol, no problem. How much it will be? 10 minus 0, 4 minus 0. This will be 5/2 or 2.5 meter per second. Now, what is the slope of the curve for T less than 0? What do you mean by that? What is the slope? Slope will be 0, no? If a line is horizontal, if it is a parallel to x-axis, the slope must be 0. I think you know very well the same thing. The slope of the curve in the interval of time, 4 to 7 seconds, will be 0. Okay, let's come for this one. For the interval of time, what is the slope? Slope will be negative. It will be 5 minus 10, 9 minus 7. So minus 5/2. So 2.5 meter per second. What do you mean by negative? The velocity negative means, what does it mean? It is changing its direction of motion. So how that motion occurs practically? Okay, the is what very important. So let's start like this. First, it will cover a distance of 10 meter. Then afterwards, it will start moving in the reverse path. Let me indicate two. So there's a first, it will move along positive x-axis. Next, it will start moving along the negative x-axis. So here it will move with a speed how much? 2.5 meter per second. Here it will move with a speed 2.5 meter per second. The total distance, how much it will cover? 10 meter. Next, it will move 5 meter. So how that motion actually occurs? For first 4 seconds, t equal to zero, it will be here. And till 4 seconds, the body will cover a distance of 10 meter with a speed 2.5 meter per second. It will come here. Then next for another 3 seconds, it will not move. It will be at rest. So even t equal to 7 seconds also, the body will be there only. Then it will start moving towards left. I think it's very simple. No, you just walk for 4 seconds. Then for another 3 seconds, you don't walk. You'll be there only. Then another 2 seconds, you reverse, come back. And like a return journey, you make it 5 meter, you walk in the return path. Then you are going to finally stop here. So like a, we have just made it here, that one. It's not like I didn't made any horizontal line just here. Till here, what we have to discuss the motion. So next again, finally, you are here at 9 seconds. So how the motion occurs? First, you are going to walk for 4 seconds. Then another 3 seconds, you don't walk. Then another 2 seconds, you are going to take the return path. So what is the total distance moved by the vehicle? 10 meter plus 5. So the total distance moved will be 10 plus 5, 15 meter. Then average speed is asking, how you define average speed? Distance covered by time taken, 15, total time of journey, 9. This will be the average speed. What about average velocity? Displacement by total time. What is the net displacement? This is the initial. This is the final. What is the net displacement? 5 meter, no? Final portion minus initial portion. So this will be 5 by 9. Average velocity it is. This is the average speed. So from position versus time graph, can you calculate the instantaneous velocity? S. That's what I'm showing. So what is the speed of particle at 2 seconds? 2.5. What is the speed of particle at 5 seconds? 0. What is the speed of particle at 8 seconds? Somewhere here. Minus 2.5. So can we predict in what direction it is moving from position versus time graph? S, the slope. The object is moving towards left, you see, after 7 seconds. If the slope is positive, the object is moving along positive x-axis. Slope negative, the object is moving along negative x-axis. So from FT graph, we can predict the direction of motion. I think I'll write all the conclusions here from FT graph. FT means position versus time graph. What all you can calculate? Instantaneous speed. We can find or determine, we can find instantaneous speed. This is the one thing. Next, direction of motion. Third, distance covered. Fourth, displacement. Fifth, average speed. Average velocity, all these quantities you can determine. By slope, what happened? We can find out instantaneous speed. This is very important. The slope in FT graph will give the instantaneous speed. So, and the speed is constant. You see, everywhere for 0 to 4 seconds, the slope is constant. Speed is constant. So, uniform velocity motion. For 0 to 4 seconds, what is the type of motion? Uniform velocity. Then, for 4 to 7 seconds, body will be at rest. I'll write all these things. What is the difference? For 0 to 4 seconds, body will move with this much of speed. 4 to 7 seconds, body at rest. or vehicle at rest. Now, vehicle moves along positive x-axis. What about here, negative sign? Vehicle moves along negative x-axis. It will change direction of motion. So all this information is readily available in this FT graph. It's very, very good. Lot of information, just the mere graph, no? You can see that so much of things we are exploring. Able to analyze? Let me save it. Okay, let me take the next problem. So I think the ST graph, position versus time graph, is really very, very important. Almost the total motion it is able to, we are able to describe. So therefore, in the books, no, rather than expressing something instead of say like a, instead of describing so much, no, I'll just put graph. The graph will speak so much of things. That's why you have so many numericals based on the graphs. This much of information is hidden in the graph. This is the idea. This total, what all I scribbled, this everything is there in the graph. Getting the method. So definitely, Altman, the interpretation of graph in kinematics becomes very important. What you have to interpret slope in a given graph, the slope at a point, what quantity it will reflect then. Area under the curve, what it will reflect. Positive or negative, if the value is positive or negative. So what do it indicate? I think these are the three things, if you can notice, they'll be sufficient. I think everyone knows now slope. In mathematical tools, you have learned how to calculate slope, or even in high school. That ideas is what you should apply here. Similar thinking, what happened, you are supposed to apply here. The position time graphs for two children A and B returning from their school O to their homes P and Q respectively along the straight line path is as shown. Compare their motion. Let me help you. See, look at your teacher. Your teacher is trying to explain through the physical diagrams. This is what you are supposed to imagine. Both will move along straight path. So their ohms are there. Okay, this will be the returning from their school. Oh, so that the school is over that one. Okay, I'll draw the school. A school building may not be very okay. Then this is the home. In the same building. Yeah. Okay. This is that O. This is for A and B will write it. Okay, and this is school. Now what we have to really interpret from school O to their home. Okay, now look at what do this vertical distance will give? The distance of their homes to their homes here. Okay, this is the P, this is the Q. Nothing wrong in drawing such diagrams. I'm telling you this one, nothing wrong. In fact, you are learning a lot than formulas. No. So what is this y-axis will indicate? The distance of their homes from the school. Look at this, which distance is more? QO greater than PO. So is it this correct? Okay, no, the ohm Q should be farther from the school than ohm P. So it should be like this. Okay, this is justified. Two children A. Okay, children A. This also is children B. They will run with a speed. They'll walk or run. Okay, whatever. Now, let's analyze here. So from the graph, what we can say that one, the ohm Q is farther than this, the position or say the distance of the ohm Q is more than that of the ohm P nu. So XQ greater than this one, ohm Q farther than ohm P. This is the one thing. This is the interpretation of graph. You can see this. Next again. Who will start? I think A will start. A will start early, no? So how to say that one? You can see like this. The moment T greater than zero, the person A starts moving. What about here? The person B, after certain time, he will start. Let me indicate this time. T dash or any other another T dash, let me indicate. So when B will start. So who will start early? A will start early. What is the time of journey of A? It is T naught. What is the time of journey of B? T naught minus T dash. This is the total time, T naught. This is T naught minus T dash is the time of journey. A will start early, it is. Okay, they're one thing. Next again. Third point, what are other things we can put it like it? Who is having more speed? The slope in ST graph will give the speed. So definitely looking at this. So here, the distance speed of A is what? PO by T naught. Speed of the B will be the slope. Slope is how much it is? Like a QO by T naught minus T dash. So definitely what you can expect here, VB greater than VA. A will start early, the speed of B will be greater than speed of A. Now, what about the average speed? I think average speed initially both are same, no? Will they cross each other? Yes, at one particular point. You see, like at one instant. So first, what will happen? The A will start. B will be still in the school. Somewhere when A is here, then the B will start. Somewhere they'll cross each other. That's what you can see here. That they cross each other. So what is the next thing is like B. Both the kids cross each other. Each other, or you can say like, B will start later. And O takes A. So it's like this, no? B will start later. B will start later. You will start later, but somewhere you will overtake A, and both will take, both will reach simultaneously at time T naught. Both will reach. The destinations are different. Though B will start later, what will happen? Both at same time they are going to reach here, and somewhere you will overtake A also. That also we have information. See, it's a very simple, just two lines, but having so much of information. So definitely if I want to compare motion of two particles, shall I write information like this or shall I plot graph? Better to plot graph. So the graph speaks a lot in kinematics. We'll take the next one. Regarding the average velocity, instant velocity. So in a motion, so will they be equal or not equal? That will try to analyze. the first case. If I calculate slope in FT graph, what do I get? Incident velocity. And the particle is moving along a straight line. And look at the slope at any point. Slope is same. So you calculate slope at 1 and 2. So slope at 1 is equal to slope at 2. So with this, what we can conclude here, the speed of particle is same. So definitely what I can say, no, the body is describing uniform velocity motion. The body describes uniform velocity motion. In uniform velocity motion, let me again calculate the slope. I think you know this will be theta. This will be delta S, delta theta. Slope tan theta V1, V2 is equal to tan theta. And it is also equal to, okay, this much will write. And how you define average velocity? Delta S by delta T. Again, it is also equal to tan theta. From geometry, what you can write it? Tan theta equal delta S by delta T. So therefore, what is V average? So in uniform velocity motion, so what happened to average velocity? Here, average velocity is equal to instantaneous velocity. What are V1, V2? V1, V2 are instantaneous velocities. And what is V average? So in uniform velocity motion, average velocity should be equal to instantaneous velocity. Maybe if particle doesn't change its direction. In this particular case, it is in fact 2. What is the conclusion I can make it? V average bar is equal to V instantaneous bar. This is a conclusion. I'll make it a little bit smaller. Yeah, fine. Okay, there's the one best conclusion I'm bringing. Okay, let's come for the second diagram. Let me calculate the slope at point 1 and point. How to calculate slope? The method is very simple. I'll show by different color lines. There's a one slope. Okay, it's very simple. There's a 0.192. So here you measure angle theta 2. Here you angle made by tangent with horizontal. We know in FT graph, the slope of tangent drawn in FT graph at a given point will give instant velocity. So looking at the diagram, where theta is more, definitely theta 2 is more than theta 1. What are these green color lines? They are tangents. At 0.192, I drew the tangent. Then I'll measure that angle. Theta 1 and theta 2. Theta 2 is greater than theta 1. Then tan theta 2 will be greater than tan theta 1. What do you mean by tan theta 2 slope? So slope of curve at 2 greater than slope of curve at 1. So in FT graph, what the slope indicates? Nothing but the instantaneous speed. Okay, look at now. Is it uniform velocity motion? The answer is no. In uniform velocity motion, the particle will describe equal displacements in equal intervals of time. Here, it's not like that. It's not in uniform velocity motion. Sir, how do you can show like that? If speed varies, it is not uniform velocity motion. So here, I think one graphical interpretation is a must. There's a curve, there's an experimental curve, what we have. I'll try my level best. Particle should cover equal time intervals, I'll take it. Just give some time. I'll set right things here. The distance between horizontal lines should remain same. Yeah. Now let me bring the corresponding to that vertical lines produce horizontal lines. You can beautifully see the interval is same. This interval is same. Delta T, delta T. What about here? This is delta S1. This delta S2. Okay, agreed. Okay, now you have very beautiful information in front of you. What about average speed in the interval of time delta T at point one? This is 0.2. Delta S2 greater than delta S1. So what will happen to average speed? Average speed is going to be different. V average at 2, it is greater than V average at 1. Previously, sir, can you show for previously also? Let me arrange the diagram. We'll move a little bit up, no, so that we'll get a space to scribble all this one. Okay, now you have everything visible for you. Similarly, let me go for the graph for this uniform velocity motion. This name not needed. Okay, there's a graph. I'm plotting the graph. Already I discussed, once again for your convenience, I'm repeating it. Straight line. Okay, the straight line is not here. No, here also you go for the same thing. Equal displacements in equal intervals of time. Vertical line, black color. If you measure this delta S, it will be same. And this delta T will be same. And these are the points 1 and 2. Look at average velocity. Average velocity at 2 is equal to average velocity at 1, which is equal to delta S by delta T, which is nothing but equal to V1, V2 also. Already I just indicated. A very beautiful information is what I'm presenting here. So look at in this graph, I think. Look at the graphs here. So in this graph, the instant velocity, the instant speed was equal to average speed, or instant velocity equal to average velocity. What about here? The particle is having different speed with the time at point one, it's having one speed. At two, it's having a speed. The speed of particle is increasing. It is speed is increasing. It is, in fact, is accelerating better, you can call. Now calculate the average velocity at 2 and 1. Definitely at 2, it is more than 1. At 2, it is more than 1 year. So look at the now, is it uniform velocity motion? No, it's a non-uniform velocity motion. The body describes. Non-uniform velocity motion. So is it V average, S V average not equal to instantaneous speed. Incident velocity, can it be zero? Not possible. Everywhere non-zero. Average velocity, non-zero. Both are non-zero here. Able to compare this? It's a non-uniform velocity motion. If you get a curve in ST graph, non-uniform. If you get a straight line, it'll be uniform velocity motion. Similarly, let's interpret the third graph. So let me choose the points, experimental points. So there's a 1, 2, 3. Okay, let me just magnify it. Now look at the points 1, 9, 2. At 1, what is the slope at 1? First, we'll calculate the slopes at various points. Slopes at 1, at 3, and slope at 2. I think, is it visible? I'll further magnify so that I think there's a maximum magnification. Clearly see this, slopes. Slope at 1 is positive, slope at 3 is negative. Slope at 2 is 0. So V1, what we can conclude here, V1 is positive and greater than 0. I'll V2 less than 0. V3 less than 0. What about V2 equal to 0? Slope negative means speed will start moving towards negative direction. What about average velocity? You look at the initial position, final position. The net displacement is zero, no? So what is average velocity for this time interval? It'll be zero. And what about instant velocity? It's zero at one instant. And what about average velocity for the points for this interval of time? Non-zero. What is the conclusion we can make it here? Average velocity, can it be zero? Yes, it will be zero for some interval. Average velocity can be equal to zero. Maybe zero, I'll write it. Average velocity maybe zero for, not zero for all intervals, maybe zero for some means only for this interval. For this interval of time, it is non-zero. So only for some interval. What about instant velocity? It is zero, no? At some instant. Is in fact zero. At 2, the velocity is zero. At 1 and 3, it is non-zero. So therefore, if average velocity is zero, then instant velocity must be zero. Need not know, not a necessary condition. Here both can be zero. And at 1, both are non-zero. For this interval, if you take it, no, instant velocity non-zero, average velocity non-zero. At 2, what happened? Instant zero. And for average velocity means we should go for interval. So during this motion, what we can say that one, average velocity may be zero, maybe non-zero, correct statement. Instant velocity at a given instant will be zero, will be non-zero, correct statement. At this instant of time, non-zero. At this instant of time, zero. At this instant of time, non-zero. Average velocity for interval 1, 2, non-zero. For interval 1, 3, will be zero. Maybe zero for some interval. At some instant of time, it will be zero. And V in non-zero at some instant of time, it will also be non-zero. We'll take the next condition. You can see this clearly, the position. So is it possible for average velocity to be zero? Not possible. Average velocity will be non-zero for any interval. Now, what about instant velocity? It can be zero here, no? 1, 2. At 2, the slope can be zero. no. Average velocity will be non-zero for any interval of time. You can clearly look at this condition. So you look at this interval, you take it, or from here. If you take it for this interval, it can be zero again. For any interval, maybe zero, you have to write it, not must be. Instantaneous velocity is, in fact, maybe zero. At two, it is zero. At one, non-zero. At one and three, it is non-zero. And average velocity or an interval, if you choose this is interval, it'll be zero. If you choose this is interval, non-zero. So for any interval, maybe zero, you have to write, not for all interval. I think the same curve. So somewhere here, the slope can be zero. One non-zero. So is it uniform velocity motion? Non-uniform velocity motion. Non-uniform. Velocity motion. Similarly, again, V1 non-zero, V2 will be zero, V3 non-zero. Vin, like maybe zero, I can put that statement. Vin, maybe zero. What about average velocity? The same idea. For any interval, maybe zero. Both are same, these two diagrams. No, if average velocity, let's come for this one. Average velocity is zero. What about instant velocity? It can be zero. It can be zero. Not a necessary condition. Here, what happened? Instant velocity is not at all zero. You can see that one. So where the slope is nowhere zero, that one. So V instantaneous, non-zero. V average can be zero. So in a motion, if average velocity is zero, instant velocity must be zero, need not. You compare this. Here what happened? Instant velocity has become zero. If average velocity is zero, instant velocity may be zero. It's some instant of time. So what is the condition? If V average zero, V in must be zero, need not. Vin may be zero is a correct statement. Like this, we have to interpret. So here Vin is Vin instant zero and the V average also. Though it is zero, but V instant non-zero. If you take this sum interval, this interval of time, V average also will become non-zero. So shall we put a conclusion? If average velocity is zero, instant velocity must be zero. Wrong statement. If average velocity is zero, instant velocity may be zero, correct statement. If instant velocity is zero, average velocity must be zero, need not. We don't have any such code. If this is zero, this must be zero, nothing like that. It all depends upon the type of motion. So what is the conclusion we can make it here? If V average zero, V instantaneous may be zero. If V average non-zero, V instantaneous, may be zero, may not be zero. So there's no any specific rule that if this is zero, that must be zero. And that's what I just wanted to interpret by so many examples here. Let's conclude with the help of some sentence. If velocity is constant, then speed would be constant. But if speed is constant, then velocity may not be constant as direction may change. Is it a correct statement? If velocity is constant, then speed would be constant. Then speed would be constant. But if speed is constant, then velocity may not be constant as direction may change. I think it's correct. No, the statement is correct. If velocity is constant, then speed must be constant. I'll give another example where it will change the direction. Here, it will continuously will move in same direction, particle one. If velocity is constant, then speed would be constant. Yes, it must be, no? There is a correct statement. But if speed is constant, then velocity may not be constant, direction may change. As if you see this, it is moving with a speed V2. If velocity constant, speed must be constant. If speed is constant, velocity need not be constant because there can be change in direction. I think the justified, I just give an example with the help of these things. So for this statement, there's a diagram. For this statement, there's a diagram. If a particle is moving with constant velocity, then for any time interval, average speed is equal to magnitude of average velocity equal to speed equal to magnitude of velocity. I think that this again will take help of the graph. Then you go for the slope. If particle is moving with a constant velocity, so I think if a particle moves with a constant velocity, this is a position versus time graph. This is a delta t. This is a delta s. So what is v average delta s by delta t? This is also equal to v, no? Since it is moving along a straight line, so no change in direction of motion. Then for such a motion, the magnitude of average velocity or average speed, magnitude of velocity or the speed, everything will be seen. If a particle moves with a constant velocity, then for any time interval, either again you pick up time interval here or here, anywhere, any time interval, this will be a valid one. Particle is moving in a straight line without changing its direction of motion, then speed equal to magnitude velocity. Average speed over an interval should be equal to magnitude of average. I think the same thing, just know. Average speed over an interval should be equal to magnitude of average velocity. Both are same, no? Instant speed and average speed may differ. I think for a particle moving a straight line without changing its direction of motion, then instant speed and average speed, no, it will be same. Compared to that statement, no, a particle is moving along a straight line. I'll push it here. Okay, look at the this statement, particle moving without changing the direction of motion, then instant speed and average speed may differ. Not wrong statement, no? It's a wrong statement. Huh? The velocity of particle is constant, then average velocity for different intervals would be same or different. Will be same. You can take any interval of time. Everything through graph, better to interpret so that will be easy for us. Now, if I take this, for different intervals would be same. Different intervals is telling. So the intervals of time, I'll change it. Let's see what we'll get it. Look at the intervals of time. I change it correspondingly. This is delta T1, delta T2. Delta S1, delta S2. This is the position. This is the time. What you can say about the slope? Okay, I'll just shade that triangle. Please look at the triangles, which I'm going to shade it. What is the slope of these two triangles? Will be seen. Tan theta 1 is equal to delta S1 by T1. Delta S1 not equal to delta S2. Delta T1 not equal to delta, but still the average speed will be same. And this should be equal to what? The average speed, or it is also equal to instantaneous speed. In uniform velocity motion for different intervals, even then the intervals of time you take it, that definitely the corresponding displacements will be different, but the ratio of displacement time taken will be same. I think this will be same or different. So what we should say, same. I'll strike it out. Getting no, all these are not theoretical questions. We should analyze with the help of graph. Last one. If average velocity of a moving particle is zero for a time interval, then instant velocity at some instant within this interval may be zero. I think we have just now discussed everything. It has come in the form of sentence. If average velocity of a particle is zero, is telling. Let me extend the graph. Yeah. This can happen. It can be like this. No. You have very best information in front of you. This is one interval of time. Next, we have another interval of time. There's an interval of times we'll choose, delta T1. Delta T2, there's a position. There's a time. So for position 1, 2, V average is what? Will be zero. Agree this? For time interval, okay, A, B, I'll write it. So symbols. SA equal to SB equal to SC. So the time interval. So this, let me call this a first and this is second one. So V average for the first, it will be SB minus SA by delta T1. V average for the second interval of time, SC minus SB by delta T2. So this will be 0 by delta T1, 0. 0 by delta T2, 0. Average velocity, no doubt 0. What about the instant velocity here? Here it can be 0, no? And here nowhere it is 0. And at 1, at some other points, non-zero. So in this interval of time, instant velocity is 0. In this interval of time, instant velocity is non-zero. So what is the interpretation? In interval of time, instantaneous velocity may be zero, or is zero, you can write. At one point is zero, at other point non-zero. In an interval of time, delta T1 instant velocity is non-zero. Next point. in interval of time delta t2, instant velocity is non-zero. Now you interpret yourself. If average velocity of moving particle is zero for a time interval, then instant velocity at some instant within this interval may be zero. Yes, no? It is zero, yet it is non-zero. Must be zero, wrong statement. Maybe zero, correct statement. So there's a correct statement. Agreed? I just know what we discussed earlier, that's the same set of problems. it's a position versus time graph. You calculate what you get, you'll get a slope. Okay, now let me indicate, let me read question. The diagram shows the position versus time graph of two cats running opposite to each other between two fixed points. Then cat A has greater average speed, cat B has greater average speed. Both cats have same distance and both cats are moving with constant speed. Okay, now what is it? Actually the diagram? The diagram will be like this. Both are having same displacement. Correct, no? So this is a cat B. I think I can't draw the cat. Yeah. Appearing like a dog. There's a cat. So it is running. There's a cat B. Okay, there's a cat. There's a cat. So they will cross each other. Both cats are moving. Now, which is having, so you look at the slope. There's a slope theta A. There's having a slope theta B. So tan theta A. Cat A is, so now you look at the displacement. So what I suggest is like, is asking the speed, that one, both are having same displacement. What is the time of journey of A is more than time of journey of B? This will be a little bit difficult. Let me analyze here. This will be delta TB, time of journey. There's a time of journey of cat A. No, both are having same displacement, delta S. So what is VA now? VA will be delta S by delta TA. VB will be delta S by delta TB. Delta TB is less than delta TA. So therefore VB should be greater than VA. So the speed of the cat B is greater average speed. The conclusion. Then both cats have same displacement. It's correct, no? Both are having same displacement. Both cats are moving with constant speed. This is also correct statement. Two particles A and B are moving along a straight line. Describe the motion of particles in following cases. How A and B are moving. So both are having same displacement. Green color and red color, I should take. So both are having same displacement. Both will take same, like a different time of journeys are different. You can see from here. This will be the time of journey of B. I'll write it here. delta TA. This will be delta S. So VA delta TB. So delta TBE is less than delta TA. So VB greater than VA. So who is having more speed? The B particle B is having more speed than A. Who will start early? A will start early. And both will reach the destination simultaneously. Like this, we can interpret. Both will cover same displacement. You can see that the speed of A, the speed of B. Both will cover same displacement. Okay, no. Again, we have to interpret. So this will be the so the time of journey of both are different. This is delta TB. Both will start simultaneously. Both will start simultaneously in this case. So A will start earlier. A will start earlier than B. Both are having same displacement, but the speed of B is greater than A. Now what happens here? Both will start same, but with having more displacement, B is having displacement. B will overtake A. So who will start? Both will start. Okay, this graph, I'll do correction. It should be like, yeah. The destination is same. You can see from this data here. So no, what about the speeds? What we can write here? Both will take same time. So like the time intervals are different. The slope of B you have to calculate and with the slope of A. Theta A. This will be theta B. So tan theta B. Tan theta B will be greater than tan theta A. So VB greater than VA. So if this is having a speed VA, this is having a speed VB. And B will overtake A. I think just now I discussed the cat one. So here, both are moving opposite to each other. A and B are moving. A and B are moving opposite to each other. They will cross each other. Then both are having same and VA equal to VB. The graphs will predict so much of information hidden in graphs. Okay, I'll take the next one. Okay, let me read this question. A man walking from town A to another town B at the rate of 4 km/h starts 1 hour before a coach. Coach means like some bus or anything. It can be tramway or any bus or vehicle. Also traveling from A to B. The coach is traveling at the rate of 12 km/h. And on the way, he is picked up by the coach. On arriving at B, he finds that his coach journey lasted 2 hours. Find the distance in kilometer between A and B. I think it's all about the diagram, I feel. This is the A and B, town A. So I'm taking up of diagram to explain. No, there's a easiest way of working physics numericals. These are the stations. These are the two places, A and B. It's asking the distance between them. So at t equals zero, the man here, he will start walking. So what is the speed of the man? That could be Vm, I'll write it. Then at a rate of 4 km/h, we know that one, starts 1 hour before a coach. The coach is here only. The coach is here. Coach means the truck only, I'll take it. So somewhere I'll draw it here. There's a coach, and after 1 hour, the coach will start. No, so there's a time. 1 hour, and the person open in that 1 hour, he will cover some distance. He'll be somewhere here. So how much of distance he will move in 1 hour? 4 km. Now the coach will start. No, able to understand? The man will start his journey earlier. He will start walking. Then after 1 hour, now the coach will start walking here. So the coach, and I'll rough diagram. It'll be like this here. So the coach, what happened for first 1 hour, the coach will be attached, the man will walk. Now, by the time somewhere the coach, what happened, will pick up the man. I'll place the what is this? Yeah. Okay, the man will be sitting on it with a zoom. So this distance, we don't know. Let me excel. So this, the coach is traveling at a rate, and on the way is picked up by the coach, this one. So what is the time? We don't know this. Let me call T2. Finally, the man and the coach will arrive at the other end of the other point B. So what is the time? 2 hours. His coach journey is lasted 2 hours. So from here, what happened? The journey will start now. So this will be hour. So what is the speed of the coach? 12 km/h. 12 km/h. I need to move for 2 hours from here. Yeah, look at this one. This 12 km/h. So for 2 hours. So what is this distance should be? 24 km. There's a velocity of coach, and the man will be in the coach. He will not move. The coach will move now. Okay, we have this much of information. I think any student, if he's able to interpret the problem like this, you can work out very comfortably. Okay, let me look at the man. For man, what is the equation we can write? 4 plus x should be equal to 1 plus T2 over. So what is the distance covered by the man? Distance like from A to from this position to this position. How much of distance the man will walk? So the man, what happened? First 1 hour he'll walk. Then the coach will start after 1 hour. By the time coach catches the man will be still walking, no? So by the time man moves a distance, like the coach will, how much of distance will move? 4 plus x. So therefore, total distance moved by the man to catch the coach will be 4 plus x. In what is the time interval? 1 hour. Time of walking, 1 hour plus T2 hour. With the speed Vm, there's a one equation, you keep it. Then for the coach, what you can write? 4 4 plus x should be equal to velocity of coach into only t2. Because what is the time taken by the coach to catch the man? Because altogether it has to move a distance of 4 plus 6. With what speed? With a speed vc. In interval of time, t2. So there's the equation 2. So what are the unknown things? vc we know. Velocity of coach, 12 kilometer per hour. Velocity of man. Four kilometer per hour. Okay, solving this equation 192, I'll get x and v2. So like a x, I'm getting, I think, 2 kilometer. T2 will be 0.5 hour. But what was the distance? Our question is to get that the distance AB, no? So what is the distance AB? You can write it as 4 plus x plus So 4 plus 2 plus 24, 30 kilometer. It's a very general problem. If you are moving from your home to the college, then you have walked. Then meanwhile, the bus started and the bus will pick you up. Then sitting in bus, you reach the college. Nothing big, no? Why you should take physics book? The very general things you might have noticed in your life. I'll indicate the colors a little bit easy for you. Okay, this will be our answer. The distance AB is what that is asked. Let's take the next problem. Let me save the data. Read the question. Okay, read the question. From a town, car starts at regular intervals of 30 seconds and run towards another town with a constant speed of 60 km per hour. At some point of time, all the cars simultaneously have to reduce the speed to 40 km per hour due to bad weather. Simultaneously, all the cars, I think this is some point, all the cars simultaneously have to reduce the speed to 40 km per hour. I think this will be going to help us a lot. Due to bad weather condition, what will be the time interval between arrival of the cars at the second town during the bad weather? Don't search for formula. Just take help of. So there's a station A. We'll take it out, town A. There's a town B. One car will start. Okay, let's assume that the first car will start. I'm unable to draw the car. Okay, this first car will start it. For every 30 seconds, a car has to start the journey. I need some set of diagrams. I will decrease this so that we'll get enough space. Okay, no, I think you are able to see things clearly, A and B. Now there's the first car. Okay, we'll give number one. Then again, what about the second car? It will start after 30 seconds, no? So it will be here. Second car will start. I'm trying to explain the concept so that it'll be easy for you. 2, 3. This is a 2. Car 1, 2, 3, like this. Now look at this one. So what is the speed of all the cars? All the cars, 60 kilometer per hour. At t equal to 0, this will start. After what time? 30 seconds. Next, again, this will, I think I'll indicate like this. Again, this will start. What be the distance between them? I'm interested in this distance. Will it be same as the distance between cars should be same? So how to calculate the x? So there should be equal to x should be equal to 60 kilometer per hour into 30 seconds. I think this will become 0.5 kilometer. So the distance between the cars now will remain same. Now due to bad weather, the speed of the cars now will reduce to 40 kilometer per hour. Then what point the distance will remain same. The distance is not going to change. So somewhere bad weather has come. I'll bring those three cars. I'm just taking only three. So you have to take plenty to make concept, to understand the concept. I'm just only picking up three cars. So due to bad weather, all will change their speed simultaneously. So what do you expect the distance between them will remain same still x only? Because all will change their speed simultaneously. The distance between them will remain same. Now, what is the time interval? The first car will enter now. The first car will reach. Next, second car will reach. The first car now is about to just enter the station B. Next, afterwards, okay, I'll do one thing. Why it is not coming? Yeah. I'll show it here. The car one is here. I'm not responding. Let me save and see. Mm-hmm. Okay. We can edit, no? Okay, I'll do one thing. I have alternative. I'll edit by white color. Okay, now look at this for every. So what is this distance? Again, will remain same, will not change. The same x only. So after what interval of time it will reach here? So there's now the car two is at station B. After some time, the car three will come here, no? The car one was here. After what time the car two will be at station B? It has to cover a distance x. With what speed? 40 kilometer per hour. So therefore, what is the T2? The T2, what we can write is earlier we wrote T1, no? Earlier 30 seconds what we wrote it. So I'll do one thing. V1 into T1. So now this is V2. The speed has reduced. So what is X2 now? the same x what we can write it as v2 into t2. So what is x? 0.5 kilometer for 40 kilometer per hour into t2. This t2 is what is asking. So 45 seconds it will come if you calculate. For every, so here after 45 seconds, car one is at station B, at town B. After 45 seconds, car two will come to the station B. For every 45 seconds, one car will enter the town B. This idea. So I feel like at least through diagrams we can solve. It's not that only through diagram. Very easier method. Anybody can draw cars. Anybody can draw straight lines. Anybody looking at diagrams. Anybody can write equation. Now, what is this x? So look at the car one. Earlier it was here. Now it is here. So it has moved a distance x. So what is x is equal to? Speed of the car into the time interval. Finish short. So we'll get the x. So since all cars will change the speed simultaneously, even after raining, the distance between the cars will remain same. So here some more rain occurs. Blue color clouds will show it. Here rain occurs. So because of that, they'll decrease the speed. Let me take the okay, these are the some types of numericals what I have picked up. Few more are there, let me cover in the next class. I think I just took the lot of content what I gave here. In the next coming class, what happened, we'll discuss few more problems. Okay, kids, like today's class, we had a discussion on the applications of uniform velocity and instant velocity, uniform velocity, some graph problem. If they give question, how to solve, we should draw a physical diagram, one physically what happens. Looking at that diagram, then what happened? We will write some equations. Then known things, unknown things, then the set of formulas. So try to look at the methodology to solve the problem, not like something question I'll read, some formula is there, I'll dump something in the formula, I'll get answer. Not possible. So slowly with a small numericals we have started. So read the question, what actually going on, express that, take help of some straight line. Okay, body moving along straight line, particle, in place of particle you can assume a person, you can assume a vehicle, car, bike. Show that they are moving, that they are differentiating their different positions. Then look at the question data, try to indicate it, speed, distance, time, what all given. What is unknown thing? How to write some equation, then solve. You may get answer. So make a habit of solving physics questions. Until unless you don't solve questions, concept clarity will not come. Just mere reading theory will not help you. You have to put effort in solving numericals. Okay, tomorrow we'll continue from here. Okay, thank all of you. Take care. Bye, kids. See you.